Thanks for joining us. Got my friend Greg here. We're going to talk about a lesion on his arm. But first, Greg, our families go back.
Yes, a long ways back.
Am I correct? Your brother performed my brother's wedding in 1977?
Yeah, is that right? Yeah.
Okay. So that happens a lot in primary care when you practice in your hometown. You end up practicing on people that you go back with.
That's right.
This thing here has been here for how long?
I don't know, several years.
Okay.
I think it started out as a little more of a skin colored bump, and then I think it actually, I kind of scratched it a number of times. I think it might have kind of almost like dried up and fallen off once or twice.
Okay.
And then it's kind of just become more of a place to put my hand and irritate it.
Yeah.
And I'm getting tired.
It just asks for you to scratch and.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about.
So it's a good thing. And it does get sunburned a lot. So it's might make a lot of sense to get rid of it.
It's changed color. There's some kind of a change there.
It's gotten a little bit darker. Yeah.
And these are the kind of things, if we go over the ABCDEs, we have videos where we go over that, but we can review them again. A, asymmetry. If you have a skin lesion and cut right down the middle, do the sides look like mirror images of each other? And this one pretty much does. It's got that one. B, border irregularity. If it doesn't have nice, smooth, rounded borders, we get concerned. And this one looks pretty good, actually. C, color, if there's variation of the color, especially if there's three or more colors. And this has a pretty dark color, make us consider it might be a problem. D is diameter greater than 6 millimeter, and it's not quite that big, but it does come right up to that. And then E is evolving shape, size, or color, and it definitely has that. And these are things that make us think, maybe we should take a look at it. When I look at it with my eye, I think two things. One is it's probably just a seborrheic keratosis, just a benign, warty type growth that we get. Some people refer to them as barnacles. But also with that dark color, and it really looks different from other things I've seen on your skin, kind of the ugly duckling principle of if it really stands out from the others, probably a good idea to check it. So I think it'd be best if we did a punch biopsy rather than just a shave biopsy, because when what we're concerned about is a pigmented lesion, something with color or darkness, dark colors in this case, we want to get down in the deeper levels because there can be something deeper that we don't want to miss. And then if it did turn out to be a cancer, depending on what type, we'd have to get it addressed either here in the office or by a dermatologist. Mm-hmm. So I'll be giving you a shot here with lidocaine with epinephrine, which I'm told, you can feel the shot there, sorry. Mm-hmm. I'm told is actually hard to find in our area right now. Polly just told me to be real conservative with it, but I don't want you bleeding all over the place, especially with a punch biopsy. With a shave, it might be different. You might be able to go without the lidocaine with epinephrine, just use lidocaine. Is it stinging?
I'm amazed at how smooth it is. That's
smooth.
Just incredible.
Yeah. Smooth.
Not very painful.
Okay.
So the epinephrine is to mitigate bleeding?
It does, and that's more of an issue.
It restricts the blood vessels in the area.
Keeps the medicine from leaving. Also keeps blood from getting in. I'm going to put a drape over your arm to keep the area around where we're working sterile. A 5 millimeter punch biopsy in this one, because we want to have the least amount of scarring possible, so we try to orient kind of an oval rather than a circle by stretching the skin before we go in.
Oh, and that allows the surface to kind of pull back over.
Yeah, so that you get a bit of a good shape. So this part of the arm, I want to have the scar going kind of this way. So I'm going to stretch it out this direction. And I'm not going to get the whole thing, but I'm going to get a lot of it. Look at that, probably don't even have to do much cutting. I'm going to put it over in a specimen container. And that'll be evaluated by the pathologist. And then,
how deep did you go?
I went all the way through the skin. And at this point, it is How many millimeters? Between 1 and 2 millimeter. But it looks deeper because once you get through the skin, the connective tissue underneath is very soft stuff. It's made up of fat and other tissues that are called connective tissue. And they're just kind of loose down there. You have big plans for the weekend? Labor Day weekend.
Well, we're trying to come up with some plans.
Trying to come up with some. I think that's the same weekend as Burning Man. And sometimes we'll go up to Tahoe area and see all of the traffic coming back from it. And it's like a white dust that covers everything.
The messed up vehicles.
And it gets on the interstate. So it gets on your card, even though you didn't go.
Well, we live in Colfax, so we get to see all kinds of broken down vehicles on the way out.
I don't mean to pull your hair there, but man, your hair and the suture are right together.
You should
have shaved you, huh?
You could still.
I could still do it. I could get the whole procedure done and then do it. but that doesn't quite make much sense to me.
Probably. Yeah, Burning Man. Pretty funny stuff.
Thank you for joining us. Special thanks go out to Petra Rosenberg and also to Meg Lightbone, a couple of our higher level Patreons, and you can find out about that at patreon.com/Auburn Medical Group. Greg, thank you so much for letting us carve on your arm, and we'll put in the description of the video or maybe even the title what the result is, depending on what we find out. And we'll let you know before that, which will be in just a couple days.
Great.
Before the holiday weekend.
Very good.
All right.
That's awesome.
Thanks.
You're an awesome doctor. I always appreciate being with you.
Thank you. Thank you. The check's in the mail. Until next time, Greg, Dr. Mark Vaughn telling you to stay in good health.